quite some time. Ooh, yeah. And I'm not too sure who's in control of mine.
I'm gonna borrow a few styles on this one if you don't mind. Let's go. Kill him with a little bit of kindness. Minus Miller in the middle of the minus. Minus divvy at retail. You give me my 3 sales, but kitties in the video behind us. Minus killing every last city we run through. You're late to get the message. I'm a 50 gun shoot. You're hating on the present, but the method is done cool. You're done fool. I'ma let you wait for the 1-2. Salute to the general Tech 9. Moving subliminal, but they let us get by. Trying to sign, you'll never catch Rex Ryan. If you battle, it's mine. I smile, I'll tell you next time. Just another early warning from another alien in a dirty storm. And give me just a million, and I'm good for torn. And hung over like a fuck, but I'm up.
Good morning. Early in the morning, yeah. When she's all alone, I'ma sneak into a room, put new shit on the phone. I'ma have her hooked on that strange music and mayday. Hey. Early in the morning, when she's all alone, I'ma sneak into a room, put new shit on the phone. I'ma have her feeding for that strange music and mayday.
Alright, I'm gonna pull my dick out on this one, so you probably wanna step back.
Sippin' on a KCT like Aquafina. Chillin' in Miami with a Bartolina. Stock is cheaper, blocks are greener. Then again, I probably shouldn't drop this ether. While the walls all shaded Easter, mushrooms got me looking at some crazy features. Now I'm in here feeling like Satan's teacher. Nah, I'm kidding, I'm an atheist preacher. Get it poppin' while I'm all up in the Denver scene. Next to me, up in the Texas dream. World's out of shape and we bent the beam. Shit, pregnant teens are taking mescaline. I'm that menace with the roaring drum. Killing time, waiting for the next quarter run. I'm the new cold killer, feeling horse with fun. So you motherfuckers know that when the morning comes.
Early in the morning, when she's all alone, I'ma sneak into a room, put new shit on the phone. I'ma have a hook on that strange music and mayday. Hey.
Y'all ready? Bring it in.
Early in the morning, when she's all alone, I'ma sneak into a room, put new shit on the phone. I'ma have a feeling for that strange music and mayday. Early in the morning, when she's all alone, I'ma sneak into a room, put new shit on the phone. I'ma have a feeling for that strange music and mayday. Hey.
Let's go.
Reverse hyper.
I tweaked something, huh?
Yeah, my bicep, I don't know what's what happened, but I went to adjust by holding the grips, so I went to adjust my whole body and something popped, but it's not, I still have full range of motion, and it's really, really sore, but I don't know, just have to keep an eye on it. If it was a snap or anything, it'd be bruised already and in a lot of pain, but I don't know, it may have been one of the smaller hits on the bicep or something, but it hurt pretty fucking bad, so just have to let it rest.
Did you announce, are you officially announcing what you committed to, or are we waiting on that?
I didn't officially announce it, no.
Wait.
I told Chad, but...
You want to wait on your own blog?
Probably, yeah.
Okay. Ooh, you guys are all wondering now what's up. Huh, I'm not going to tell you. So, he did that this morning, and then I had this really bright idea for my PIC Corey and I to go in and do a 20-minute wad and then end it with yoga, because we always do our Saturday morning yoga together. So I picked a wad, and she said, well, I got it off of our friend Madison's Instagram. She did it the other day, and I was like, oh, that one sounds good. It doesn't sound too bad. And Corey said, that sounds terrible, but whatever. So it was 20 minutes, as many rounds as possible, 5 deadlifts, 5 hang cleans, 5 front squats, 5 push press, 5 back squats. So it was terrible. So first we were like, okay, well, we only had about 30 minutes before yoga to get it done. So we said, okay, let's do 15 minutes, you know, and try and get through it. And then 15 minutes turned into 12 minutes. 12 minutes and turned into, let's just try to get through 5 rounds without dying. Corey actually did a really hardcore wad the night before with Brian. And so she was already pretty wiped out. Her upper body, her shoulders were dead. But she pushed through. And I know if we had really tried harder, I probably could have gotten at least a couple more rounds. And she could have probably gone heavier and gotten more rounds. But we still got our heart rates up and burned some calories and we're sweating. But it was hard. And then Corey and I have a bad habit of laughing and talking and, you know, going through making it even worse. So it was kind of stupid. But then we went and did yoga, and that was awesome and just what I needed. And so we got through that, and then I met up with Scott over at Clarkie's, and now we're on our way. Right? Right. So that's what we're doing. And then last night was really fun. We went over to our friend Tiffany and Jason's house. They have, they're getting new floors put in. They're getting new floors put in on Wednesday, so they've been living on just concrete throughout their living room and kitchen. So they had a concrete jungle party, which we all went over. There was a ton of people, actually. We went over there, and they had Sharpies all over the house, and we just decorated the floor. So that was fun. There were a lot of food and snacks and friends, so that was a lot of fun. We were there for a few hours, and I'll show you in this video. You'll see clips from that night, as well as mine and Scott's kick-ass creation. We got pretty creative, didn't we, babe?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You did.
Yeah. Well, you contributed the house. Anyway, you'll have to see it. It's pretty cute. So now we're here in AG. It's a rainy day. And then I think we're going to probably head home after this, and it's a Twilight Marathon day, huh, babe?
Yeah.
Yay! I love me some Twilight Marathons. And that's it. Big kids are with their dad till tomorrow, and I feel like it's Sunday, but it's only Saturday, so that makes me super excited. Because yeah, last week was freaking long. Now we got another week of amazing busyness, as always.
Yeah, it'll be busy.
But it's good. It's all right. And at some point,
I'm ready for Saturday.
I know. What's Saturday?
The house part.
Oh, that's right.
Christmas and everything.
Well, we have a big thing on Friday too.
What's Friday?
Friday morning. Anyway. And that, and I feel like there's something else we're missing. I really want to see that Disney movie, though, at some point, hopefully.
Friday
before.
Morning, what the fuck are you talking about?
Well, I'm not saying it on here. Maybe I didn't give you a...
Craig told me about
maybe
it.
Maybe I didn't give you the date. Maybe I just told you what we're doing.
Yeah, what the fuck are we doing?
Oh, well, we're going to go now. I'm going to leave it at that. So.
Didn't I give you all that I've got to give, baby? I keep
I keep trying for you.
There's nothing like you and I, baby. This is no ordinary love. It's no ordinary love. This is no
when you came my way, you brightened every day. With your sweet smile,
with your sweet smile.
Tell you what I believe. Did somebody say that a love like that won't last? Didn't I give you all that I've got to give, baby?
This is no
to my son's basketball game in Santa Maria. It was the third day of his tournament. He had a game Thursday, Friday that I could not go to. So I was booked with a tanning in the evenings, and that's when the games were. And then, so I went this morning, and of course they won their first two games of the tournament, Thursday and Friday, and then today they lost. So kind of a bummer, but they did good. It wasn't a like total big loss. I mean, it was a loss is a loss, but I mean, they weren't too far behind in the score. But so I did that, and then on my way home, I stopped at San Luis Obispo at the Vets Hall, where my friends Leah and Megan are there at a craft fair with a booth, doing their thing. So that was kind of cool. Some cool stuff. I didn't buy anything, but there was some fun stuff there for sure. So now I'm headed home. Go collect Scott and Cruz and go get some lunch. My Trey and Gianna and Steven were, I had asked if they wanted to come with me to Trey's game, because his dad, he couldn't go because he was getting work on his car done. So I thought they would go, but they ended up going. They had a free throw contest that they participate in every year, and they win every year. And this year they both took first place. So I got those excited text messages that they got first place again for both of them in their age group. So then in probably about a month or so, the Elks Lodge is who puts on the free throw contest. They will have prize awards or trophies for them, and they feed them dinner and have a special little award ceremony. It's pretty cute. Our little community does some fun stuff. So that's what's going on. And I woke up today, a married woman. Crazy, still seems weird. So I should be like, oh my gosh, you're married, and let me see your ring. I never, to be honest, thought I would say that again. I am not because Scott didn't want to marry me, but because I didn't think I would want to get married again. So it's kind of a whole thing. So yes, if you didn't see our post yesterday, thanks for all the love, everybody. We did get married yesterday. We did a little courthouse wedding with the four kiddos, and it's official. So, I mean, official. You know, we already went to the Social Security office and everything. Crazy. So yeah, that's what's going on. I don't know if I'm having a good makeup day or what, but I got a few compliments on the makeup and skincare, but my skin. All I can think is it's the limelight shining out on me. So yes, if you haven't checked out my website, do it. I want you to try these amazing products. You won't be disappointed, I promise you. I'm gonna start trying to get together with some of you that have been wanting me to assist with makeup and skincare, and do some little limelight play dates at either the studio, or I can come to you, start getting that done. I know the holidays are crazy time, so I'm gonna try and get it done with some of you earlier before it gets closer to Christmas. So that's going on. I am about just over halfway to my first promotion with the company. I've only been with them for a couple weeks, so that's pretty exciting too. So anyway, I'm starving, and I just forgot what I was gonna say. Oh yeah, oops, sorry, I put my arm down because I was getting tired, and I don't like looking like a weirdo and people driving by me, but tonight at Gigi Pa's house, the O'Farrells, where actually Scott, like, we're staying right now while we get ready for our new home, they are planning on selling their house, and this house has been in the family for many, many years, and they've decided to sell and get a little smaller place, since once we're out and Scott's brother Brandon's out, they won't be needing such a big home anymore. So they've decided to sell. So it's kind of bittersweet for their family, as they all have lived there, grown up there, many holidays, families, everybody's been there. So kind of a big deal. And Scott's gone all out with the Christmas lights. They are everywhere. Like how, sorry, my nose rings all jacked. When Scott was growing up, and they would deck out the house with lights, and as everybody's gotten older, they haven't been doing it as much. So Scott really went all out with the lights. We're gonna have anybody that wants to come by tonight between 6 and 9. All the lights will be on. We'll have hot cider, Christmas music, and just a fun little way to kick off the holiday season and the last holiday in the O'Farrell house. So come by and check it out. Even though by the time you watch this, this will already have happened. But anyway, my arm is dead. I gotta go. So have a fabulous weekend, and I'll talk to y'all soon.
There's nothing like you and I, baby. This is no ordinary love. It's no